you tell us which roles you originated in Dizzy's New
Dizzy? I originated the role of Catherine Plummer.
There were 60 boys in the room, and at some point, Chris Catelli, the choreographer, said, at some point, he said, now we just did the dance, we did some singing, now just show us your tricks. And one by one, all 60 of those boys started doing the craziest tumble passes, the craziest jumps, leaps, turns, whatever it was, juggling, doing the craziest circus tricks that I ever saw. They could have casted all 60 of those boys in the room that day, and the show would have been just as good. I don't know how they narrowed it down, but then they picked, I think, 18 of those 60 were in the original cast at 8
Wow. What
crazy.
Trick did you do?
I did a round of triple back and spring tuck.
That is a wild.
10 years ago.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, I forgot where it looks like. No, it was exciting because of all the people that were in the room. Oh, my goodness. I didn't do a tumble pass, but I got to sing with Jerry Durant for my final audition.
For me, Newsies was that too.
I felt. He is amazing. The Newsies would go, just tell me, like, how do you say this?
It's
how do you
so
say
funny.
This? How do you say this line? How would you say it?
That's another funny audition story, actually. Oh my gosh, I'm sorry, we go on tangents. I can't stop. But in the audition, actually, I raised my hand and I asked a question. I was like, what note, or like whatever it was, I don't know, something about the music, or when do we cut off here? And everybody turned around and looked at me, and then I forget who it was. Was it Jeff Calhoun? He goes,
that's our director.
Director of Newsies. He literally goes, everybody, in case you were wondering, talk like him. So that felt pretty good.
We can't hear you. Your mic's off.
You're so much talking. So for me, I was trying to find a female in 1899, the turn of the century, that was a journalist. And I did find a female, but one that I clung to is Nellie Bly. Not that she was directly connected to the Newsies, but she was covering a lot of big political stories, and it took a very specific type of personality. So I clung to her and I researched her quite a bit, but then also looking at what New York City looked like in 1899, for me, I'm so visual. So I just needed to look at what the world was like then, beyond obviously their brilliant set, but seeing, we walk through New York every day, and it was 2012. But, you know, we had our cell phones and all these things that were bringing into the theater, and for me, I just needed to see what was it like.
What did it look like then? So you needed to see the pictures. Yeah. I remember that too. I did the same thing. Yeah, I mean, I feel like at the heart and soul of Newsies is that it is based on a true story. It's what the story is about. It's the camaraderie of the Newsies and the Girlsies. That was what the show is about. So I think that it was important to always remember that and always go back to it. This is based on a true story. This actually happened to some kids. They had nothing. They had no one but each other. And I think what made the show so successful is that the relationships that the Newsies had on the page and back in 1889 was reflective to the relationship that we had in 2011 when we put the show up. We became brothers and sisters. We became a family when we put this show up.
And still are.
We still are, yeah, we really still are. And so, yeah, that's what I think what made the show what it is.
Theater family is the best family. I so speaking of, what were the fans like outside the stage door?
I was not prepared.
Me neither.
Fancies.
I'm so sorry.
Woo! Newsies fans. The fansies are the reason that we made it to Broadway, truly.
Yeah.
I think the intention initially was that the show would be done for licensing, but the fan following was so strong, and the support was so immense, and we felt that.
Yeah.
And it was so wonderful, because we were just grateful to be working, and to be working with this brilliant creative team. And the expectation was not Broadway, but the fans demanded it. It was like art imitating life. Like, they were like, must go to Broadway!
We had people flying from all over the world to see our little show in Paper Mill Playhouse, New Jersey. It was unheard of. Speeds up. So I thought since I ate the nuts an hour and a half ago, I was in the clear. Nope, my throat starts to swell up again. This is like 15 minutes before the show. So I go backstage and I said to Karen, she said to me, my sister has a
nut allergy. And I was like, if you need me to do the EpiPen, I got you.
So the throat starts to close. I go backstage. I'm like, Kara, can you help me? I'm having a nut allergy. What'd you say?
Well, Capathia was awesome. Capathia, who played Metal Rock and we shared the dressing room. And Tommy comes in with his bare leg.
Yeah, just like, hey, so we need to use it. I think he needs to use it.
I was like, I can't do it.
So, Capathia. your tickle over and she was like, okay, it's going to be fine, don't worry, let's read the instructions. It says, pull it out, pull the cap, give it a stab, that's it, that's what we're going to do, and that's what we did.
Coming, have no fear, for boys
terrific, right? Hey, from my point of view, I felt like she was singing right to me. It looked like it. It felt like it. Hey, has anyone been, done one of our summer programs, anyone out here?